tour, we're going to take a look at drawing clouds with chalk pastels or soft pastels. I'm working on toned brown paper, and the first thing I'm going to do is define my sky. When you're working with pastels, you want to approach it like painting. So I'm going to start with the area that's the furthest away, and in this case it's the sky, and then I'm going to work downward from there to the areas that are closer. So I start with just a dark blue and bring that value down, and then I'm going to take a light blue and work my way up in kind of a mid-tone blue in between, and then I'm just going to use my fingers to kind of smear everything together. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take white and just go along the bottom of the horizon and bring a little bit of lightness up to the top. Now I want the top part to be a little bit darker, so I'm going to grab a brown and I'm going to add that to the blue, and what that's going to do is make a natural darker tone. And I'm going to blend that in again with my fingers. And I went back over it again with a little bit of blue just to give it a cooler feel. And I'm going to give a little bit of an indication of atmosphere by adding a little bit of light blue on top of that. Now I'm ready to start adding my clouds. And as I said before, I'm going to work from what's furthest away to what's closest. So I'm going to start with the clouds that are off in the distance. And I'm just using white here, and I'm going to have areas where the white is more concentrated and areas where it's less concentrated. The less concentrated areas are going to naturally make a little bit of shadow because clouds are three-dimensional forms. Here I'm accentuating it with a little bit of blue and a little bit of gray, and the reason why I'm using the blue with the gray is because the gray I have is kind of a warm gray and you want kind of a cool gray for your clouds. Now that I've got a good indication of the clouds in the background, I'm going to start working on the clouds that are closer to the viewer in the foreground. It's not technically the foreground, but just a little bit closer to the viewer. And again, I'm using a photo reference, and I'm just looking at the shapes that are happening in the photo reference and trying to copy those shapes as best as possible. And in my photo reference, I noticed that some of the clouds kind of break apart from some of the other ones, so we'll have some flying up there in the air. Now, like I said before, clouds are three-dimensional objects, so they're going to have a highlighted side and they're going to have a shadowed side as well. In this case, my highlight is going to be on the left side primarily, the left and top of the clouds, and my shadows are going to be on the bottom and right side of the clouds because my light source is coming from the upper left-hand side of the image. I'm going back now with some dark blue to kind of create some more of those shadowed areas in the clouds, and again with the gray. And at this point in time, I'm just basically putting down color, doing a little bit of blending with my fingers, but not too much. Just trying to locate the colors that I see in my reference and put those colors in my drawing. Now I'm going to go back with the white and highlight again, just to bring out some of those highlights and make the light source seem a little bit more believable. Now I'm going to take some of that white and kind of let it go in a horizontal direction towards the bottom of the clouds here and there to make the base of the cloud seem a little bit flatter. I'm also going to use the white to kind of blend in the gray and the blue to make it seem a little bit more powdery, make the shadows a little bit smoother. And this is really going to make our clouds seem a lot more realistic. Now I'm ready to move on to the foreground, create some contrast between the sky and the ground. And in this case, it's a mountain scene, so I'm going to start with some purple off in the distance. I'm going to accentuate that with a little bit of blue. Smear it in just a slight bit, and then I'm going to add some white to that to create some atmosphere. Now I'm going to take the base tone of some brown and create the shapes of the mountains that are closer to the viewer. Also smear that in as I go. You can see just by adding this, our clouds and sky are starting to pop, creating that contrast that we need for the clouds to be representational. Now I'm going to take a little bit of yellow green, go over the top of that brown to create a little bit of an illusion of grass. I'm also going to accentuate that with a little bit of blue, create a little bit of indication of shadow, to create some highlights with a little bit of the white, keeping in mind that my light source is coming from the left side. A little bit more white to add a little indication of texture. Then I'm going to accentuate it lastly with a little bit of yellow. And there's my completed image of clouds using chalk pastels.